you come to South Sudan, you will not leave South Sudan as the same person.
Hello. How are you?
We cannot trust him.
I'm worried about Dorsa every day.
I sometimes surprise myself. I never thought that I would be built for such context. If you tell me there's another mass casualty, I will shoot myself.
In suburban Perth, three generations of the Nazemi family are getting together for a summer barbecue.
It's hot. I give it to you.
I love hot.
This dish we're cooking is called a chicken kebab, which is a very native and quite a popular Persian dish.
But not everyone's here today to enjoy the feast. A beloved daughter is missing.
Dorsa missed a lot of time of the family, and she loved my kebabs. Ready?
Well, she misses this. She misses everyday stuff.
They miss her affection and good-natured bossiness. And they'll never get used to the fact she chooses to work in one of the most dangerous countries in the world.
Every night, Dorsa's comments in my mind, is she, you know, safe? Is she okay? It's not easy, you know, your child is, you know, war zone.
My mom would be very happy that in the middle of the bush I'm applying mascara. The only thing she'd be happy about.
It's a long way from Perth to this hot and dusty airstrip in South Sudan.
Hi, this is Dorsa. You sent an email regarding the evacuations from Motot for tomorrow. Okay, one crisis managed.
Dorsa has one of the toughest gigs you can imagine.
Where are we going?
Running operations for the International Committee of the Red Cross in the state of Jonglei, at the heart of one of the worst humanitarian crises in the world.
Now, I just got approval that we can go to where there was a tribal attack, where people had lost their belongings, people were killed and wounded.
And meanwhile in the background.
We are at an airdrop distribution point in the middle of nowhere, where we provide food from the air.
Okay. Red 2 control. I'm clearing the aircraft for the first drop. Any issues from your side?
Everything is okay.
You drop a pin anywhere on the map of South Sudan and there are needs. It's a huge burden on your shoulder and it keeps you, well, it certainly keeps me awake at night.
Red 917, you're clear to drop.
Excellent drop, gentlemen, excellent drop.
Why are you actually dropping food here?
Well, this is a country that is currently going through a protracted war. There is civil war, there is communal clashes, people cannot stay in one place to cultivate, so you have humanitarian aid to try to bridge the gap.
South Sudan's vicious civil war has driven millions to flee the country. Millions more are at risk of starvation without foreign aid like this. Not many of us would make the sacrifices necessary to do this job. But Dorsa insists she's no hero.
When they say, oh, well, you're a humanitarian and you must be a saint or you are saving people from death, and then they put you on a pedestal, we're none of that. This is bigger than you. It's much bigger than you.
For the past 6 months, this has been Dorsa's home. A fortified compound in the town of Bor. There's a strict 8 p.m. curfew, but even here, you're not 100% safe. Just a few weeks ago, three other NGO compounds in town were attacked and robbed.
You like cooking?
Yeah. It's the only time that my brain does not wander off to work.
Their office is in Jonglei, one of the most volatile regions in South Sudan.
How's it going?
Good morning.
That makes it one of the most challenging areas for the Red Cross to operate in.
Security checks need to be done on time. We're going to be on the field more often than not. Now that the dry season is upon us, we can.
At their morning meeting, Dorsa warns her team to expect an increase in hostilities.
Just the way that we're busy, the two parties to the armed conflict are also going to be busy. That means that it is even more important that you stay alert and vigilant. And I made myself understood. Yes. Very good. Have a good day, guys. Bye.
The main aim of the International Committee of the Red Cross, or ICRC, is to help victims of armed conflict. To do this, Dorsa has to think like a military commander, but at the same time, act completely neutral. A skill she honed after postings in Nigeria and Afghanistan.
I just put myself in the minds of the two parties to the conflict and tried to guess where would be the next possible offensive. Where would the population move to? Because the minute the clash would happen, they just disperse. And that's key, because the minute that they move, that's where we move to assist. Some people would say that this is a military strategy. It's survival by default.
Maneuvering around South Sudan's war safely is incredibly difficult.
In South Sudan, where hundreds have been killed in fierce fighting, the violence started Thursday in the capital of Juba.
The country is cracking apart as fighting engulfs new areas. Towns have been burnt down and civilians raped and massacred. But this wasn't how the story of South Sudan was supposed to go.
As the president of South Sudan, I shall be faithful.
The world's newest nation was born to great fanfare just 8 years ago, after a long, bloody struggle to split from Sudan.
And will never allow political power to be transferred through violence.
But a bitter rivalry quickly developed between the new president and his vice president.
We have declared his regime illegitimate.
They splintered the country along ethnic lines. Dinka versus Nuer.
There are dead bodies on the streets. Some of them look like they've been here for days.
They are targeting Nuer. For instance, if you are speaking Nuer language, you will be targeted.
How did it all go so wrong so fast?
when suddenly people cannot agree on a way forward, it creates doubt, it creates distrust, and when there's no trust and there's no dialogue, then things fall apart.
Dorset's trying to help the people caught up in this war. To do that, she has to negotiate with all sides, so local knowledge and connections go a long way.
In the context of the northern part, or what we call the opposition-controlled areas, it is very useful to have someone who's from that area, because I'm a white girl from Australia who would not understand the nuances.
Today, as she heads into rebel territory, she's taking a trusted guide.
Ready, girl.
Ruach Gartbel is Nuer, and this war is personal. His mother and daughter live close to the front line, but years of working for the ICRC have taught him to think beyond his tribe.
In the heart of humanitarian, although your family members are affected by war, you need to remain as a humanitarian workers, whereby you can be a neutral at any time.
We're heading to a town where Dorsa and Ruach hope to help people who've lost limbs as a result of the war.
Welcome to Old Fangak.
Thank you.
In the rainy season, we could not even walk down here because all the mud would get stuck to our boots.
They want to bring a mobile prosthetics unit from the capital, because in rebel areas like this, amputees are often afraid to travel into enemy territory to get help. But Dorsa will need the local governor to guarantee the safety of workers from the capital. Trust is in short supply during a civil war. It won't be easy.
I got coffee. If I fall, forget about me, but the coffee cannot be wasted. Because, boy. Oh, hey, Masket, you want to put your camera down? I put you a little coffee.
All right.
Dorsa's job often takes her close to the front lines, and when it does, she has to let both sides know what she's doing.
It is essential because with this context, you never know when the first bullet is going to be shot, so you have to make sure that they know that we're coming. You would be quite naive to think that the danger is not around the corner.
According to the UN, South Sudan is the most dangerous country in the world for aid workers. 28 were killed just last year, including an ICRC driver. That's one reason why diplomacy's a big part of Dorsa's job. Terrible atrocities have been committed by all sides of this conflict, but she's not here to judge them.
How are you?
Dorsa, nice pleased to meet you. How are you?
You too.
There are amputees who may not get the prosthetics they need unless Dorsa can get Governor Kwal Wai's cooperation. This is the first time they've met.
I want to gauge your interest. If we were to create a mobile service in an opposition-controlled area such as Old Fangak, how would the security of these technical staff that work for the authorities on the other side can be guaranteed by the authorities on the other side? We need to make sure that they are not going to be arrested or harmed or so on and so forth. If you know, you catch my drift.
It is a good program for us because even in New Panjang now, there are some wounded who are looking for how they can actually manage to get artificial legs. Now, bringing technicians from Juba, can we trust them? That's the bigger question. Yeah. We cannot trust them.
It sounds like a no, but Dorsa's not deterred.
It's open to discussion. When you drop an idea like this on anybody's table, you need to give them time to digest it.
For now, without trust between the two sides, the rebels can't accept much-needed help for their own people.
Civilians are our number one priority. We don't.
It's only the reputation of the ICRC that keeps the option on the table.
You obviously know that they are also sitting down and talking to all sides in this conflict, to people that you consider to be your enemy. Why do you trust them?
No, I know ICRC is neutral. They have no problem with anyone in southern Sudan, and that's why we trust them.
Yes, thank you. Thank you so much. It was a pleasure meeting you finally.
Is it hard being friendly to people who might be responsible for doing unspeakable things?
If I let my personal feelings about the person who's sitting in front of me get in the way of me having an objective view of what I'm trying to achieve...
I'm not asking about letting them get in the way, but do you have those feelings?
Of course, otherwise I would not be human. But then would I let that cloud my judgment? I cannot afford that because they will sense it. It's neutrality is not just me, or confidentiality is not just the same. Amos, it's living it.
The ICRC's neutrality is key to everything Dorsa does. She might not be publicly critical, the way some other aid workers can be, but she's trusted, and that's what gives her access and influence. And when the shit hits the fan, these are the things that help her save lives.
Tired?
Super tired, but satisfied. 7 people wounded. Where are these wounded?
The next morning, several lives hang in the balance.
Okay. Do you know if these 7, what they tell you, if their injuries were severe or not?
A government offensive has left 3 dead and 7 wounded.
All right, then.
They don't know if the casualties are soldiers or civilians.
Bye. So they moved out of the garrison? Yeah.
This is the village where my mother is.
This is where your mommy is?
Yes.
Holy crap, and your daughter?
Yeah.
I will send a message now to...
Dorsa needs to evacuate the wounded as soon as possible.
They just arrived. 2 wounded just... Okay, I'm gonna... Okay.
Which means getting them somewhere safe for a helicopter to pick them up.
Listen, I'm gonna put Ruach on the phone so you can explain better. Okay. Ask him where's the population.
Daniel.
Has stuff like this happened with you before, where your family have been in danger?
No.
This is the first time.
Our staff are also victims of this war and this protracted war. I mean, look at him now.
The news just gets worse.
Boss is online.
There are children among the casualties.
Number one is 10 years old, mm-hmm. and what's her or he or she?
He's he.
It's a he.
Yeah.
Poor little boy. What's his name?
Gutwich.
Gutwich has two gunshot wounds to his left leg. Dawson knows he'll be lucky to keep it.
Okay, and fourth?
Fourth is Yang.
I was just watching him to see if one of these names was going to create a reaction, and then I had to like step in. So I'm just glad that none of those names matched his family members. So I am very happy that Raj's family is safe and sound.
We have to rush to make our flight back to Bor. At the same time, Dorsa arranges for the seven wounded to be evacuated.
Can you hear me?
They'll be flown to a mobile surgical team for emergency care.
What's it going
on? Okay, I cannot multitask. All right, I will. Seven weapon wounded arrived in Motot this morning, just about 2 hours ago. Out of the seven, two are children.
With any luck, Ruach and Dorsa will have helped save seven lives today.
He's gonna keep his leg, right?
Great rinse of the blood here. Rinse of the blood.
It's a world of contradictions in South Sudan. One minute you feel peace and beauty, and the next minute you have to deal with communities fighting and people dying.
Inhale. Exhale, pivot on the back foot, lift your right heel.
If you come to South Sudan, you will not leave South Sudan as the same person.
Namaste.
Do you tell your parents everything that happens out here?
No, God, no. I think I tried the first, on my first mission, I was just explaining one of my experiences visiting a place of detention. My mom told me, no, you need to stop. And my dad just looked at me like I was an alien.
Hello?
Hi.
Hi.
No, it's winter. That's why I'm wearing a shirt like this. Of course it's hot. It's dry and hot.
She never talk about, you know, her jobs.
But
you know,
we see the news.
Yeah, we see the news.
We know the news. But she never say because she no want to we become worried.
So Aria, the biggest news is that Aria caught a frog in the backyard. That's it. You are a very, very busy family.
Dorsa's always been good under pressure.
I just ripped the T-shirt.
Arriving in Australia from Iran at the age of 17, she spoke no English. But within a few years, landed a top government job.
She was working for Prime Minister's office. And that's, you know, wonderful job. And she can, you know, stay there and wear, you know, very nice dress and makeup and everything. But she said, one day she said, no, this is not my job. I want to go to, you know, help those people who need me. These people, they don't need me. This is in Dorsa.
Okay, well, I have to go and I will speak to you guys later this week.
Love you guys. Maman, remember how to do this?
Yeah, I remember. Huh? Yes, I remember. I know. I said, my God, I did good job with Doris. I'm proud, really. This is, you know, me.
There's no end in sight for this civil war. A ceasefire agreement was signed in December that was broken less than 48 hours later. In a protracted conflict like this, it's sometimes hard to see how humanitarians can make a difference. But I tag along as Dorsa visits her mobile surgical team, who've managed to save at least one young life. Akabo is a small town on the Ethiopian border, and this is where the children Dorsa evacuated were brought just the other day.
So how many patients do we have now?
55.
55. Male. Malugwa. Yeah. So this is a child that was brought in from Motot. So how is he going? What happened to him? He got multiple shots, no?
They carried him for 2 hours on a makeshift stretcher before reaching help.
So it was a fracture, no?
Yes.
But he's gonna keep his leg, right?
Yes.
So I'm really glad that you're alive, huh? I'm very glad.
Gutwich will need further surgery.
All right, bye. Bye.
And I've asked Dorsa to let me know how it all goes.
I was really worried because I had heard that he had multiple gunshot wounds and I didn't think he was going to make it. So for him to be here safely with his family, with his mother, and yes, he's in a lot of pain, but the fact that he's alive, it makes all the efforts that we had to put through to put him on the plane and bring him here, that little bit, it makes it worthwhile, that's for sure.
The UN says more than 2,300 children have been killed or injured since the war began.
You're fine. So how's your leg?
In total, between 50 to 300,000 people have died in this conflict. It could easily be cause for despair, but the fact that everyone here will live gives Dorsa hope.
Be nice to the team here.
Yes.
All right? You can see that in the most bleak and sometimes forgotten places in the world, that there is a way that you can make a difference. I am critical of many things, but at the end of the day, I think we make more magic happen than not. And that's good enough for me.